So this character is a Genesis 8 basic mill from Daz Studio, sculpted into a stylized character here in Blender, and then rigged using Rig-GNS. So in this video, we're going to look at how we can combine different animations to create a new custom animation. For this character, I wanted to step backward while shooting this rifle. So I'm going to need two different animations, one where the character is holding a rifle and another where the character is moving backward. Now in the anime setup, I will click this get option and then select get Mixamo, which opens up the browser to the Mixamo website. I already have the website open on this tab, so I will close this one. So here I'm going to search for a rifle animation first and see what I can find. You can see there are a variety of rifle animations here. I'm going to pick this one where the character is basically standing in place holding the weapon. I'll go ahead and download it, set the skin option to without skin and click download. Alright, so the next thing is I'll search for an injured walk animation. Something moving backward. So let's preview this injured walk backward. Okay, I think I'll go with this one. But first, let's enable the in place option. And then go ahead and download that as well. Alright, so now that both animations are downloaded, let's switch to Blender. Alright, so in the anime setup, I'll click import motion and then choose the Mixamo option. And for my downloads folder, I'll import the rifle animation first. Once imported, I'll click the bind button and then orbit around to see how it looks on the character. You can see we have these poking issues around the shoulder. We can try to correct these in the adjustment tab down here. So here I'll select these shoulder bones and then click the tilt button to tilt it on the z-axis. Hopefully that should fix the poking. It doesn't. Let's not spend too much time fixing the poking issues, as that can be done after the animations are combined. So after importing the animation, we've only bound the animation to the character, we haven't yet baked it. When we click the unbind button, we shall see that the animation is not yet baked to the character's rig. So I'll click the bind button again and then click bake. Let's set the frame from 1 to the very last frame and then click OK. Now we have the animation baked to the character's rig. Alright, so the next thing is I'll import the second animation, which is this injured backward walk animation. Click the bind button, then press play to preview it, and then click the bake button and then OK. Now we have both animations baked to the character's rig. Now we're going to use the NLA editor to combine the two animations. First, let's split the screen and then switch this to the NLA editor. In the NLA editor, you'll see we have the injured walk animation currently active. So let's click the push down button to move that to the NLA track. With that push down, let's return to the anime setup and select the rifle firing animation. So this rifle firing animation is now the current active action in the NLA editor. Because the active action is layered over the injured walk animation, this top animation would override the one under. However, disabling certain bones in this top animation will allow those corresponding bones in the bottom animation to influence the rig. The goal is to combine specific body movement from one animation with different movements from another animation. In our case, we aim to match the rifle aiming from the rifle firing animation with the leg movement from the injured backward walk animation. So now with the rifle action still active, I will now switch to the adjustments tab, but let's first play the animation so we can see what is happening in real time. Now I'll click on this field and select the thigh bone from this list and then click on this eye icon to disable that, and immediately we can see the thigh movement from the injured walk animation on this rig. So let's continue doing this for some other bones as well. Let's disable the shin, the foot, the toe bones, and the torso bone. Now you can see we have an animation that combines the rifle aiming from the rifle firing action with the leg movement from the injured backward walk action. You can experiment by disabling some additional bones like the abdomen to see how it affects the result. So once satisfied with the animation, we can then click the push down button on the rifle animation as well to have both animations as tracked in the NLA. Now let's proceed to bake the animation by clicking the bake button. Go with the entire frame range and then click OK. Now we have a new matched animation. So let's rename it to injured firing rifle and remove any unnecessary numbering at the end. Now that we have the combined animation, I will delete the two original animations from the NLA timeline, leaving us with the merged animation that incorporates both the rifle aiming and the backward stepping movement. Okay, so next I'm going to position the rifle so that the character appears to be aiming properly. Since the rifle is already parented to a rig, I will adjust the rig instead to align the rifle with the character's arm. First, let's pause the animation and return to frame 1, as it is always best to make this adjustment at the starting frame. Now I'll position the rifle using the scope so that it lines up with the character's eyes. Because the character's body is slightly slanted, I will need to tilt the rifle as well. I'll do that using the throat bone. Now with the rifle positioned, let's now set up a bone that will allow us to control where the rifle is aiming. Now to do that, let's go to side view, hold down shift and then place the 3D cursor somewhere around the center area in front of the character's face. Okay. So now let's switch to edit mode and press shift A to add a new bone. We can scale it down as needed. So once that is done, let's return to pose mode and select the rifle's root bone. We are going to add a damp track constraint to ensure the rifle always points towards the newly created bone. So with the root bone selected, let's go to the constraint panel, click add bone constraints and select damp track, and then set the new target bone as the target. Now when we move the target bone, the rifle should always aim at it. Alright, so the next step is, we're going to make the rifle move along with the character's body movement. So it means we would have to parent the rifle's root bone to a suitable bone on the character's rig, and we're going to do that to the chest bone here. So with the rifle's bone selected, let's go ahead and add a child off constraint. We will choose the character's rig as the target and then select the chest bone as the parent. Okay, so before clicking the set inverse button, make sure we are at the first frame. And then now we can click set inverse so that the rifle aligns correctly where we want it. Now when I play the animation, the rifle should move more naturally with the character's torso. Sometimes you may need to experiment with the order of constraints to get the best result. So here you can see setting the child off constraints before the damp track might give a different result. We now have the rifle moving with the character and at the same time pointing in the direction of the target bone. Okay, so the next step now is to adjust the character's hands so they properly grip the rifle. Let's first return to object mode and select the character's rig. We will now position the hands to grip the rifle. So let's switch to pose mode. We're now going to use the IK bones to position the right hand near the rifle's trigger and then the left hand underneath the barrel for, you know, proper support. So currently the arm are being controlled by the FK bones, and to switch to IK controls, let's collapse the adjustments tab here and expand the FK IK tab. So we have these four buttons corresponding to the IK FK switches for the right hand, left hand, right leg and left leg. So we're going to start with the right hand by enabling the right hand button here. So clicking on the IK FK button switches between the FK and IK bones for the selected limb. Now let's click this IK to FK button to have the IK bones match the FK bones position. Alright, so here I'll set the frame to 2, ensuring that the keyframe is created only on frame 1, and then I'll click OK. Okay, so now that I have this IK bones matching the FK positioning, you can see moving the right hand IK bone directly affects the entire right arm. So let's go ahead and position the right hand close to the rifle's trigger. You can enable this transform gizmo to make things easier, and if needed, switch the orientation from global to normal. And it's also a good idea to enable auto keying so that transformations are recorded as keyframes automatically. Okay, it does not have to be perfect, just convincing enough. So let's also adjust the arm roll by rotating it down to achieve a more natural look. Let's collapse the NLA editor since we no longer need it. And let's play the animation and see the results. You can see the right IK bone remains in the same position across all frames, not moving along with the rifle. So to fix this, select the IK bone. and add a child off constraint. Set the target to the rifle rig and the parent to the rifle strut bone. Okay, so make sure to have it at frame 1 before clicking set inverse, and you should see that the hand will now follow the rifle's movement. Now let's repeat the process for the left hand. So enable the left hand button here and then click the IK FK button to switch the IK controls for the left hand. Then click the IK to FK button, set the end frame to 2 and then click OK. Alright, so let's select and position the left hand's IK controls so the arm supports the rifle around the barrel. And once we are satisfied with the placement, we can go ahead and add a child off constraint. Set its parent to the rifle strut bone. Click the set inverse button to maintain the current position. Now when we play the animation, we can see that both hands now follow the rifle's movement. So because we want the final animation to be driven entirely by the FK bones, we will need to transfer the AK keyframes to the FK controls. So let's enable the right hand and then click FK to IK, set the frame range from 1 to 52 and then click OK. So switching back to FK bones for the right hand and playing the animation verifies that the animation remains consistent with the original IK motion. Alright, so let's do the same for the left hand. Let's enable the left hand button, click FK to IK, set the frame range and then click OK. Now when we switch to the FK bones for the left arm, we can also see that the animation also matches the IK motions. Okay, so currently you can see the character is in place while trying to move backwards. So now to create a progressive animation, first close the FK IK panel and open the adjustment tab where you will find this slide button. Let's play the animation to see the progression as it's been applied. By simply clicking the slide button and moving the mouse, we can gradually add progress to the character's movement. So we'll just move the mouse until we achieve the desired amount of progress. Okay, so next thing is let's extend the length of the entire animation. Let's make that longer. So let's bring back the NLA editor and push down the animation onto the track as a strip. So with the strip selected, press Alt D to duplicate it. Placing the duplicated strip immediately on the original will cause it to align automatically, ensuring the new strip begins exactly where the previous one ended. So let's click the match frame button to set the frame range with the animation's length. You may notice that once the timeline cursor moves onto the duplicated strip, the character resets to its starting position. So now to correct this, select the strip you want to align, then hold down Shift and then select this last strip. Now return to the anim setup and then click this align strip button, and this will ensure the animation flows seamlessly, creating one long progressive animation. Okay, so you can continue duplicating and aligning strips to extend the animation as much as you need it. Okay, so here we have extra tracks we no longer need, so we can go ahead and delete them to keep our workspace organized. Okay, so once we have this continuous animation that loops smoothly and maintains this backward movement, we can finalize that by picking the animation again and then renaming it for easier reference. So after that, feel free to remove any unnecessary tracks or strip from the NLA, and that is it, the final animation is ready. So that is how we combine two different animations into a new custom animation. I hope you found this helpful. If so, remember to like the video and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for your time. Till next time.